Hey, welcome to my most favorite hobby in the world, farming, homesteading. We got pens, breeding pens set up for the geese and the ducks. Stay tuned. Hello, welcome back to Pine Meadows Hobby Farm. I'm your host, Jerry Hansen. With the proliferation of predators on the homestead, namely skunks. Yeah, we took care of one the other day. Check out that video. We got that rascal. I'll keep my trap set out. We'll catch some more small predators, but we also have ravens or crows that keep flying down and catching and getting the eggs. So I have leftover deer netting that I used for the aviary for the turkey house, and I think that's enough to cover at least the duck pen and part of the goose pen, so it'll help dissuade those crows or ravens from getting in. That and a shotgun. Yes, I'm going to get my shotgun locked and loaded, and we're going to take care of those little buzzards. Well, they're not buzzards, but I've got to count on ducklings and goslings this year because I need to sell them because prices are going up and I need to buy feed for my livestock. If I can't afford to buy feed for my livestock, well, I can't afford to have livestock. So with some material laying around the farm, I managed to put together this goose pen and the duck pen. I got some fencing from my chicken yard. I got another roll of fencing down there. I'll finish off the chicken yard, but this one will get a separation between the ducks and the geese. During breeding season, the geese become very territorial, even with other geese over the nests. So I separated the igloos. These are nesting boxes that I got free from roadside freebies. Yes, just driving down the road, a neighbor put out a couple of igloos, and I picked the big one and small one up, and this other big one I got from an estate cleanup. Check out those videos on treasure hunting series and how I get stuff for free. But anyway, I put some straw, fresh straw in there, separated them, and then that way each goose can have her own private area, including this doghouse that I resourced from a coworker of mine. I got that free too. So one goose already has a nest in there and has eggs, but I'm just trying to keep the predators out and the crows from flying in and taking the eggs. So I've got leftover deer netting that I used in the aviary for the chicken or the turkey. I mentioned that earlier. So I'll be putting that over the top of the duck pen once I get the ducks herded in. Right now they're enjoying their time on the pond. I just was able to herd the geese in. How do you herd geese? Slowly and with two sticks, long sticks. That way you can herd them in and be patient. Just go slow.
Thank you.
So making do with the resources I have on the homestead, yeah. Jerry rigging, some conduit, some chicken wire left over, and a farmer's best friend. Besides duct tape and baling wire, zip ties. This is the second year I've done this, so if I'm going to be doing this from year to year, I should think about doing something a little bit more permanent back here, a section for the ducks, a section for the geese, just to get them separated. The problems I'm having is this drake is always trying to get a little goose action, and so he'll find a goose on a nest and he'll chase her off the nest just trying to find that little bit of goose action. Nasty little creature. So he's better off just being secluded in here with his two ducks. That's enough action for him. That's all he's gonna get. And the geese over there, well, I have got three geese and three ganders. And when the geese start having nests and start setting, the ganders become very protective and territorial. That's why I separated the nesting boxes, because yeah, there's gonna be some fighting among the gooses. And so I'm thinking about, if I'm gonna keep three sets of geese and then this one set of ducks, I gotta think about four separate chambers. So I'll plan that out for next year and collect the products to make a more permanent seasonal breeding solution for the waterfowl. Yeah, they're on lockdown right now. It is breeding season and there are predators. So I'm hoping to take the eggs, instead of incubating the eggs in incubators, I'm hoping to discover that these geese have set up nests in these boxes, then I'll just pack in the eggs in those nests and let the geese incubate those eggs, because I want all the goslings to be able to have parents to be able to, you know, keep them warm, keep them safe. That way there's no energy costs going out. So I created a bigger area for them because they like to forage and roam. And then I'll put some hay in there for them, grass hay for them to eat, because they like to graze on grasses. So I'll pick up a couple of bales of grass hay for them to be able to enjoy and be geese. So fingers crossed, hopefully we have goslings here in about 30 to 45 days. Stay tuned for that episode if we get baby goslings. Well, I'm your host, Jerry Hansen. This is Pine Meadows Hobby Farm. We're a frugal homestead tucked high in the Cascade Ranges of the Pacific Northwest, located west-southwest of Crater Lake National Park. Please stay tuned to more videos. You could do that by subscribing, then clicking that bell icon. That will alert you to the new hatchings as they come. And we got baby goats coming any moment now. One goat is actually in labor. You could do that by subscribing and then clicking that bell icon. And then also, please give us a thumbs up, click that like button, and then also share our videos on your social media platforms. Helps us out. Leave a comment, tip, be safe, always be kind. We'll see you guys in the next adventure. Bye-bye now.